Hey everybody, today I want to talk how I became a software developer, so let's jump straight in. First of all, I want to talk about my beginnings. In Romania, in high school, I didn't study anything related to computer science. Actually, I'm lying. I had only one computer science class. It was only talking about CSS and HTML, but other than that, nothing. In high school, I was studying accounting and I was preparing to become an accountant or a bank teller or anything in finance really. However, before finishing high school in Romania, I went in holiday in United Kingdom, more specifically in London. But before returning home, we thought, what if we stay here and give it a shot? Let's see if we can live in London for a while. And that's how it started. I was already 17 years old when I moved in the UK, and no high school accepted me because I was too old. Therefore, my only option was college. And mind you, in UK, college is not the same as in America. It's not university. I don't know how to explain it, and I don't know what's the equivalent in United States. However, college is what you can do after high school in UK. It's either college or sixth form. Of course, I wasn't accepted in the sixth form, so I had to go to college. At college, I had to choose between being a carpenter, doctor, IT, and all these subjects. From all these subjects, I found IT the most attractive. I can safely say that for 3 years, I wasted time at college because I didn't learn anything useful for software development. We only did Excel, Microsoft Word, and stuff like this, which didn't help me at all. After finishing college, I could only go at a university and study the subject I was studying at college. That means computer science or something related. In my case, I chose computer science, obviously. And that's how it started. I started going to university, studying computer science, which was a very, very, very difficult time for myself. First of all, I didn't speak English very well, which was super hard to understand the teachers, to complete the assignments, and everything. Secondly, the imposter syndrome hit me. I was always second-guessing me. I always thought, what if I'm not made for this? This is too hard. It's not for me. I'm going to give up. I'm not gonna do this. With each assignment in programming, I felt even more overwhelmed, and I felt even more that computer programming is not for me. However, I managed to finish a university with the best degree and get a job in the industry. But wait, it wasn't that easy. Before university and during university, I worked as a construction worker. Yep, that's right, you heard it correctly. However, I didn't like construction at all. Honestly, it wasn't for me, and I'm not very good at manual labor. So I had to find a way out, which was software development. Besides that, I worked in a restaurant washing dishes as well. So I did all kinds of odd jobs before doing software development, and I didn't always consider this as a career choice. Before moving to the UK, I studied to become an accountant, a bank teller, or whatever role in finance. I never knew that I want to become a programmer. Moreover, I didn't even like programming before. More than that, I hated it in high school. So you never know where life takes you, and it's not always straight, and not all the people know from a young age that they want to be a programmer, and so on. Why did I make this video? I made this video for people who are second guessing them and thinking that this industry is not for them. For people that feel down, for people feeling that programming is too hard, people feeling that this field is not for them. Yes, this field is for you, but with a lot of hard work, I won't lie, and many other factors as well. Therefore, always remember that I started studying accountancy, I worked as a construction worker, I worked in restaurant washing dishes, and only after doing all these odd jobs and studying different things, I became a software developer. Thank you for watching, and let me know what you think in the comments.